Welcome to the Week 9 edition of Prep Football Tonight, sponsored by National Scouting Report. Thanks to everyone that watched our first live broadcast on Facebook Live this past Friday night. It was also known as the Malik Jackson Show. The senior quarterback from Brighton had a rare night under the Friday night lights, leading his team to a huge win over Southwind. We'll talk more about this game and the 5A-8 in Tennessee and Malik Jackson's huge night in just a moment.
Now this week we have one of the biggest 5A showdowns to take place in Craighead County in a long time. The undefeated Nettleton Raiders take on the crosstown rivals of the Valley View Blazers, who are 6-2. Hootons has Nettleton ranked number three in the state in the 5A classification, and Valley View checks in at 13. Now, while Nettleton is undefeated, Valley View's only two losses have come at the hands of powerhouses Searcy and Wynn. Valley View went down to Wynn into the Yellow Jackets' home field and only lost by a field goal 17-14. Now, we'll have just a little more about this upcoming showdown in just a few moments.
Before we dive into this week's Tubetown Rivalry Series matchup, let's wrap up last week's shootout between Southwind and Brighton. A playoff spot was on the line, as well as the possibility of hosting a playoff game. Now, both teams came into the game in a four-way tie for first in the 5A-8. 119 points were scored in this one, so kick back, grab a snack. I got 3 minutes worth of scoring plays coming your way, starting now.
Jaguars might win this one, and it's going to be a touchdown, their second play of the game.
One handed off to West. He follows his blocker, and he's into the end zone. All too easy that time for three wide receivers, both two blockers ahead for Wilson. Tosses one into the end zone with one hand reeled in between two defenders. Are you kidding me? Jaguars showing blitz. They do from the near side. Jackson with plenty of time to throw in a wide open Aaron Alston in the end zone for a touchdown. Coming up again. Wide receiver goes in motion. They fake the sweep. Hand it off to Williams, and Williams runs it right at his legs into play. Now Alston's lined up here on the right side, and Chad Gatlin, you called it, sir. Malik Jackson with a run up the middle. Getting into it now. Wilson looking to throw. Takes a shot down the field. Got a man at the 25, 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown. And for the play, there's the snap, another design run on the option, and Malik Jackson with his second touchdown of the night. First and goal. There's the sweep fake. Smith lowering his shoulder. Sideline official says he's in. First in the third quarter. Jackson on the option. Will run it right up the gut for his third touchdown of the night. Cardinals with his second and goal. Quick snap. Faking the handoff to West. Jackson will run it in for his fourth touchdown of the Jackson. Jackson rolling out to his left. Tosses it to the end zone. He's got a receiver. It's Austin for a touchdown. West standing to the right. He'll fake the handoff to him. Jackson will keep it himself. And how about that? Touchdown. Handoff on the sweep. No. It fakes the sweep. And they'll run it right up the gut with Doncario. And 16 coming up. Jackson rolling out to his right, looking to throw. Flushed out the other way now with a lot of running room in front of him and a wide open receiver. Caught at the 20-yard line, at the 10, the 5. Touchdown, Cardinals.
Wow.
Malik Jackson beating Southwind. Southwind threatening right now. Second and 10. Screen pass caught by Smith across the 5-yard line, and he'll walk right into the end zone. No longer. Austin caught it in the corner of the end zone. Second and 15. And how about that? Southwind just taking a knee.
Quartarius Wilson did his best to make plays for the Jaguars, but turnovers and onside kicks put the Jags behind, and they just could not regain momentum. Dontario Smith found the end zone on the second play of the game, and a couple of more times after that. So did Jalen Alexander and Jeffrey Williams. But in the end, it was the Malik Jackson show. Jackson finished 12 of 16 for 211 yards and 4 TDs passing. Now, that's a really good night. But hold up, I'm not done. He also ran the ball 23 times for 94 yards and 5 more TDs. Folks, he scored 9 times. He asked for a car, he got a computer, then proceeded to put up video game numbers. Aaron Austin played a huge role and got 3 of those TD catches himself, while Lance West and Drew Twisdale got in on the action as well. Now, Brighton moves to 5-1 in conference play and will host Mumford this week, who is also 5-1 in the 5A8. Both teams have locked up playoff berths, but now they're battling for a home playoff game in this Tipton County showdown. You can bet we'll be scoreboard watching that one.
Now guess what? Y'all are fixing to find out what energy is all about. I am a firm believer in weight training, strength and conditioning, and improving yourself physically and setting yourself apart from the rest of the world. You can be a good athlete or you can be an elite athlete. And it is a mindset. It is a lifestyle. The ones that set themselves apart are the ones who are willing to sacrifice and dedicate their lives to this goal. My grades don't matter. If they want me, they'll come get me. My grades don't matter. I'm gonna get in. Don't you believe that? This coach is gonna look at you and say, hey, we're gonna look at his film, we're gonna see if he can play at our level. If he's a linebacker, we're gonna see if he feels downhill, okay? If he hits with his eyes up, he shoots his hands. If he's an offensive lineman, can he step, okay? Does he use his hands good? Got good hips, flexibility, does he reload his hips, okay? If he's a defensive back, does he open up in the coverage? Does he run the alley? Does he hit like a freight train? If he's a wide receiver, soft hands, good hands, gets open. Second level gear, if he's a running back, great vision, sees the hole, hits the hole, gets north and south. If he's a quarterback, throws in tight windows, throws the great deep ball, throws a good out route, deep out route, has every throw, big arm, smart, doesn't make mistakes, protects the ball, wins games. These are the evaluations you get. If you want to go to the Division I level, that's only 1.5% of 100 people. If you want to go to the SEC, the Big Ten, the Big 12, the Pac-12, or the ACC, the big conferences, that's 0.5%. That's rare air. National Scouting Report is the nation's oldest and most respected scouting organization in the world. We've been doing this since 1980. We started this. I'm one of y'all. I was y'all's age, wanting to go play college football. And that's what I do. I help get you there.
Big thanks to Larry Perrin and National Scouting Report for the role they play every episode of Prep Football Tonight. Can't thank those guys enough. They've been with us from the beginning.
And Larry, I'm sorry to interrupt, but Larry also has plenty to say. We can never get enough of his insight because he's been around this area for so long.
Right.
He can talk about all these teams, Northeast Arkansas, West Tennessee. He can probably fill us in on Alabama prep sports now.
No doubt. And his Arkansas perspective is always a unique point of view because he's seen it as a player and a coach and a scout. So he's got some insight that maybe you may not get from anywhere else.
So last week's game, huge shootout. It's got to be the highest scoring game we've ever had on
by far.
Tubetown. Yeah. 119 yeah. points scored.
No doubt. I think Malik Jackson just scored again, by the way. So he ran by my house earlier.
Yeah, he's scoring all the way up and down Highway 51 still. 9 touchdowns. I can't remember a performance like that in any Tubetown game. I really can't remember a performance like that in any high school game that I've seen anytime recently.
I can't think of a performance like that on any level. I was running through my head earlier just trying to think of some games that I've seen in person like that. The closest I can come is I saw Dak Prescott and Brandon Allen both have 7 touchdowns in a collegiate game a couple years ago. But, I mean, we're talking about high school, and you've got a kid that puts 4 through the air and another 5 on the ground. I mean, I can't do that on Madden, much less in person. I mean, that's just – it's crazy. It's unheard of. So
he was hitting him just enough with the pass to his big receiver Aaron Austin to throw Southwind off, and then he was just gashing him straight up the middle and to the outside. He must have all those touchdowns were really with inside like the 20-yard line. He was just gashing him and taking off.
Well, he was balanced. I mean, he had 5 on the ground, 4 in the air. You know, if you're Southwind, it's kind of pick your poison. What do you protect? Because if you protect one, he's going to expose the other.
And I'll be honest, I didn't expect that out of Brighton. I really didn't. I really thought Southwind would have the edge. Their line on both sides looked very strong. They looked to be very physical. And we saw what happened with Brighton at Covington.
Right.
You know, Brighton got shut down at Covington, which, by the way, won again. I believe they're 8-1 heading into the final week of the season, so Covington keeps on rolling. But anyway, I just didn't really expect that out of Brighton. Huge performance. And now they're right there at the top of that 5A8 and going to be battling Mumford, hosting Mumford this Friday night. So huge game. Talk about standing room only, sitting room only, lawn chair only. That game is it.
I mean, if you're a player for Brighton or Mumford, does it get any better than this? You've got your biggest rival is your next game. You're both sitting there with one conference loss. Conference title possibly on the line here, and maybe even home field advantage in the playoff, because with that traffic jam in the standings there, the loser of this game may end up going on the road if they don't pull this game out. So, I mean, this is as good as it gets if you're a player for Brighton or Mumford, either one. This is the kind of game that, as a kid, when you were younger, this is what you dream of. This is the scenario you want going into the playoffs, and to be able to put it on your rival at the end of the season and possibly even cost them a home playoff game. Well, like I said, it doesn't get any better than that.
Definite confidence booster heading into the playoffs as
no
well,
doubt.
Knowing you beat a good quality team. Whoever wins this contest, you beat a good quality team the last week of the season, and it was your rival, and you're prepping for the playoffs, and you get to go home. Either Brighton gets to stay home,
right,
or Mumford gets to go back home up Highway 51 and host a playoff game or two.
So. Well, and who knows, depending on how the brackets work out, may not be the last time we see this matchup, because they could eventually meet back up in the playoffs.
Well, then the whole county of Tipton is shutting down.
Better just shut down the whole county at that point. So,
but also a great way to introduce the audience to our Facebook Live. It was
absolutely
our first Facebook Live. Apologize for some early technical difficulties getting the feed started. So we came in with about 5-6 minutes left in the first quarter, and you've already missed 3 scores. Now, typically that wouldn't happen, but it was smooth sailing after that. So we picked up early in the first quarter there, and we will be back on Facebook Live this week for the huge game when Valley View goes to Nettleton. So big success. We had interaction with the folks at home throughout the game saying, hey, I was looking for it on YouTube. I found it on Facebook, you know, so people are looking and finding it.
Yeah, sure. And the thing with Facebook is it gives us a little more opportunity for interaction between our viewers. If you're watching the game on Facebook, any game of ours on Facebook from this point forward, shoot us a comment. Let us know where you're watching from. You know, if you like what you see, let us know. If you don't like what you see, let us know. We want to hear from you.
Now, real quick, how many good teams do we have in this area? We just talked about Mumford Brighton. They're heading to the playoffs, no doubt. You have the two teams we're going to be covering this week, Valley View, Nettleton. They're both heading to the playoffs. You have Rivercrest Osceola right back there doing what they do.
Mm-hmm.
Gosnell Truman. All of our 2A schools in Poinsett County are looking good.
Yeah.
Cross County, Martree, EPC, all of them are looking good and headed towards the playoffs. So a lot of good teams right here in this area.
Don't forget my Westside Warriors, too.
Westside is 6-2 right now.
Yeah, 6-2, big game, I believe. Pocahontas, I believe, is their next game. So that could be one of those games that could be, if they pull that off, that could be a program changer for Westside.
Definitely. So some of the names to watch out for in this big, big game this week. Now, we saw Nettleton already just dismantle Pocahontas third or opening week of Arkansas play. They just took control. Of course, the quarterback, DeAndre Henry, was all over the field making plays. Datavian Turner, Jaron Northern, Will Joyner, all those guys right there. So that's your big playmakers. But I've got a list here. I want to send a shout out because I've watched the highlights and went back and watched that Nettleton Pocahontas game a few times. And based on the success Nettleton has had all season long, I got to get a shout out to the big guys because they've been doing work all year long.
Oh, absolutely.
Those guys I just named, the playmakers, they're all seniors too, but it wouldn't be done without Wesley Handwerk, Ronnie Bradley, Justin Danette, Jacob Vaughn, Quervius Kane, and Drew Fryer. Sorry, paused on a few of those, got tongue-tied on a couple of those names, but I had to mention those guys because if you watch Nettleton play, if you watch film on Nettleton this year, they're pushing guys around. They're doing basically what they want to. That's why they're 8-0.
Absolutely, and as you know, anybody that follows football knows that you win the battle up front, good things are going to happen with your skill positions.
Yep. So, huge game this week. Might be a cold, rainy night, so
Could just be
prepared for that. And if you do not want to get out and face the weather elements, then we got you covered. Everybody's got Facebook, said it before.
Absolutely. Absolutely. We got Facebook. Everybody's got that. If you're a Ritter Communications cable customer, Channel 21 in Northeast Arkansas, Channel 11 in West Tennessee, we've got you covered either way. If you got to go somewhere, hit us up on Facebook. We'll have the game right there. You can watch and multitask. I get accused of that a lot by my wife. So, you know, it's there for the taking.
And it's going to be a big game. You mentioned Ryder Snell, I think, last week.
I did.
He's one of the guys. He's got 12 touchdowns on the season. Their quarterback, Joe Walzonia, has 19 touchdowns through the year. And Valley View is another thing. Here's another thing to watch out for with Valley View. Their kicker, Ben Brumfield. Valley View is actually one of those teams that will kick the extra point every single time. You don't see that a whole lot at the high school level.
Right.
A lot of teams just don't have the confidence in their kicker or just don't have a kicker on the roster, period, and they go for two a lot of times. But Valley View's not that team. Ben Brumfield is 38 of 41, I believe, or 39 of 41 in extra points all year long. Next to perfect, 3 for 6 from field goal range, with his longest, being a 48-yarder. So Valley View does have a kicker, and they'll utilize that kicker. Just another aspect of the game to look out for.
Well, and as you touched on with the skill positions, Walzonia, Snell, and Arnold, you know, it will be interesting to see if Valley View's offensive line can hold the Nettleton defensive front long enough for to make a play happen. And when you're talking with Arnold and Ryder on the Storm Snell, it's not going to take much of a crease for those guys to bust through. So that'll be interesting to see. I mean, that may be the matchup of the night, the Valley View offensive line versus the Nettleton defensive line. If Valley View can make some holes and also protect Walzonia, then who knows? Rivalry games, crazy things happen. So you could see anything coming out of this game. It's been a wild one in the past.
Ended in fireworks last year. Fireworks at the horn.
Yeah, I think it was a 4th and goal from the 1 or the 2, and I believe Valley View scored to take the win. So, I mean, you know, we're expecting another great, close, just pure rivalry game. I mean, these schools, you know, it's a good, clean hate, you know, that when you hate your rival, and this is one of those games where you just line up and see what happens.
So do you think this is going to be the kind of game where we possibly see close to 100 points again, where they just keep going at it, or is it going to be such a competitive contest it's a little bit tighter than that?
I think it'll be a little tighter. I don't know that we'll get into the 30s and 40s in the score. I could honestly see this ending up at a 28-24 or 28-20, maybe. Yeah, I don't see if it's a close game, I don't see either team getting out of the 20s. If Valley View plays, you know, if they take advantage of any mistakes that Nettleton makes, if they can capitalize, if Nettleton gives you a gift, if you're Valley View, you have to take it. You have to capitalize in order to keep that score close, because Nettleton does have the advantage a little bit on the athleticism and
experience.
Experience is a big thing going into this game. I mean, you're talking a junior and senior laden team with Nettleton, and when you get into these rivalry games, the guys who have been there before, that plays a huge role. So it'll be interesting to see what happens going forward.
So we saw Nettleton, so I was impressed by them. I don't know as much about Valley View, but I was impressed that they went to win and only lost by a field goal, 17-14. So that right there tells me we got a game on our hands this Friday night. I don't see it swinging out of hand either way.
No, I just, you know, I think there's always the potential there when you've got the playmakers that Nettleton has. You know, if everything goes their way like it did against Pocahontas, then Nettleton could blow it open. But you can't underestimate the fact of this being a rivalry game. And we see it on every level when it's the Packers and the Bears, or when it's Alabama-Auburn, or in this case, Nettleton-Valley View. Some crazy things can happen in rivalry games because, you know, I don't want to say they're not playing hard other times, but when it's your rival, you play just a little bit harder and you give it just a little bit extra effort. And sometimes that makes the difference, and momentum can play big. Nettleton's got the home field, but Valley View's going to travel well. It's not like they have a long commute to this game. So it'll be fun. I'm looking forward to it.
And you can see it on Facebook Live via Tubetown Rivalry Series this Friday night. So, but continue to check us out on YouTube, subscribe to our YouTube page, and like us on Facebook, and follow us there, of course, where we're going to be moving the games to. And the last game, this is the second to last game, folks, the very last game of the year coming up very soon. Now, these two teams may not be headed to the playoffs, but I tell you what, they don't like each other, and they're going to fight each other pretty hard. It's Hoxie Walnut Ridge to close out the rivalry series.
Absolutely. If you've grown up in Northeast Arkansas like I have, this game, it doesn't matter if both teams are 9-1 or 1-9. When this game comes up, whoever wins this game, their season is made. This is, you know, it may be smaller classification, but this is as big as rivalries get. Hoxie Walnut Ridge, there is so much history in the rivalry. I mean, there was a few years that they stopped playing because things got too heated. So I believe this is either the second or third year back. It'll be our first time ever to go to Walnut Ridge. We've had Hoxie once before. We've never had Walnut Ridge. We've never been to Walnut Ridge. Spoke with Jacob Kersey here a few weeks ago, just a reminder that we were coming up. They're all excited. I've seen some traffic on our Facebook page sharing the event, you know, and people talking about they're going to be there. So this will be another classic one for the Tubetown Rivalry Series.
Yep, we want all the students and schools and administration share the link. Make sure you know where to find the game and do not miss it.
Absolutely. Now, don't forget, we're on Thursday night next week. Final week of the season in Arkansas, they split between Thursday and Friday. Don't know why. That's just how it's always been done. But we will be on Thursday night next week, November 2nd.
That's right, to close out the Tubetown Rivalry Series 2017 version. And we're through it.
Yeah, I can't believe we're talking week 9 and week 10 already. I mean, it seems like we just got started with the Nettleton-Pocahontas game. But, you know, you look back now, that was, you know, almost 3 months ago. Wow, crazy.
Hey. Basketball season's got to hit sooner or later.
Absolutely, and we've got big plans for basketball season too. Looking forward to that. Saw the new facility at Brooklyn earlier this week. Wow, that's going to be an amazing place for us to do a ball game.
Much needed for a very tradition-rich basketball
Absolutely.
School in Brooklyn.
Brooklyn's one of those schools busting at the seams anyway with student growth and everything. This facility is amazing. It's out of this world.
Thanks for watching Prep Football tonight. This Friday night, another huge rivalry game when Valley View goes to Nettleton. Do not miss it. Might be a cold, rainy night, so if you don't feel like getting out, we always encourage you to get out and come enjoy the game with us. But if you do not want to, check us out Facebook Live this Friday night. Going to be a huge showdown.
Absolutely. Can't wait. Let's do it. Bundle up. We'll see you there.